Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. We are inside the Mallet Ice Center. The Ladies Championship Free Skate. And you're looking at Joanne Carter of Australia. She is the three-time Australian national champion and 16 years of age. There have been a number of surprises so far in the ladies' competition. Joanne would be one of them. This is her first trip to the World Championships. She's in 10th place.
Very nice opening triple loop jump.
That was intended to be a triple jump. As a double jump, it fails to give her the points she needs. Very nice pair of triple toe loops.
Championship free skate worth two-thirds of the overall score, and it lasts 4 minutes as opposed to 2 minutes and 40 seconds in the short program.
The thing to note about this skater is the security of her steps. She's very solid, the edging very strong.
Looks like she's skating very carefully, almost slow though. Looks like that was intended to be a triple salchow. She only did a double.
You mentioned this is her first trip to Worlds, and when you compare her 10th place finish in the short program with what Tara Lipinski did a year ago, being 15th overall after the free skate, it's very impressive that the 16-year-old is in the top 10 right now.
I think she's glad to get that over with.
It's almost as if she's ignoring the music, isn't it?
Right.
The three-time Australian national champion, hoping to stay in the top 10. Joanne Carter will have her marks when we return. On as 16-year-old Joanne Carter of Australia awaits her marks.
And look at this combination of moves that she does. First, a triple toe loop. Very, very strong, straight, and clean. And the second one, a little bit of lack of control on the landing. Good quality.
5-0. And here are the marks for Joanne Carter. There'll be two sets of marks, the first for technical merit. Range 4.8 up to 5.4. And now for presentation, range 4.8 up to 5.4 once again.
Sur la glace, comme the ass, Laetitia Hubert, France.
Here is 22-year-old Laetitia Hubert of France. Now, we are very close to the French border, and this is a partisan French crowd. She'll have a lot of support here in the Mallet Ice Center.
There's a lot of cowbells ringing here.
Yes, there are.
For good reason.
She's in seventh place after the short program.
Tuxedo Junction.
She's been skating very well on the practices, very consistent on her jumps. She may be attempting a triple-triple combination in this long program, but her first triple is a triple Lutz. Pitching back. Very nice.
Now watch how smooth she is, how she takes her time. There's no flailing of arms here. Very clean. Simple skating.
This, of course, the first group of skaters that we will see tonight. Final group, including the overall leaders, Tara Lipinski, Michelle Kwan, Maria Butyrskaya, and more.
And now coming up, if she's going to do the triple-triple combination, it'll be here. And it almost happened. Interesting positions in the camel spin. Change back sit.
Triple loop jump, single one. But notice right here now, change in music again. I think the multiple cuts in this music certainly weaken it. It's not a choreographic hole, a musical hole, and that doesn't help her.
Laetitia is no rookie. Went to her first World Championships back in 1991. Many people thought she'd retire this year because of injuries. She really hasn't competed internationally except for the European Championships, in which she placed 12th.
Good speed.
did very well. She's very pleased with her performance.
Well, it's essentially a very clean program.
She only had three, you know, sort of small mistakes, but very well.
Big smile on the face of 22-year-old Leticia Hubert of France after a strong free skate here at the Mallet Ice Center. Back here at the Mallet Ice Center in Lausanne, Switzerland, Leticia Hubert of France awaiting her marks. In the first set for technical merit.
Those are quite high marks. She had a fair amount of technique in that program.
And now for presentation. And both sets ranging from 5.3 up to 5.6. She is the leader in terms of those that have already skated. An emotional 2 days for Nicole Bobek since the death of her coach, Carlo Fassi, on Thursday here in Lausanne. She's needed the support of Carlo's wife, Krista, and Olympic champion, Robin Cousins. Leslie Visser talked to her yesterday afternoon.
Carlo was like my dad. He took the place of my dad, and he just took me in his arms, and he was behind me no matter what.
Do you feel that in some ways that maybe you're at the World Championships because of him, and maybe he was here because of you?
I believe I made the Worlds because of him, and because he really helped me and pushed me and taught me everything and protected me from everything. And you know, he was so happy that he was here and seeing everyone and being able to bring me here. He was really proud of it. And I think maybe he's happy that maybe he passed away here instead of somewhere else.
Do you know this, what Carlo's last words were to Krista?
From what Krista told me, that before he went, his last words were to make sure that Krista's with me tomorrow when I compete.
And do you also feel that he will be with you?
Yes, I think he will be with me no matter what. So, I know he's there. I just can't see him.
And before this free skate, backstage, Nicole Bobek much more upbeat, much more ready to step out onto the ice. She would love to have a great performance here.
The music, Giselle.
Well, Carlo helped Nicole reclaim her place on this world team, and now Nicole has to face this toughest event without him. Opening with a double axel. Good spring.
There's a far greater musicality about her this year. Much more disciplined and controlled. It's been a very impressive growing up time for her.
Been a very difficult event for Nicole.
I think she's gained a lot of admirers this week with how she's handled herself. And today, very composed, even though you know that she's also very emotional inside.
It's okay, buddy.
And she does have a chance to stand on the podium in eighth place after the short program. Thank you.
her extension first rate.
It's absolutely spectacular when she does her spirals.
Full salchow.
Besides all that she has had to deal with this week, it is quite amazing that she has even made it to the World Championships. She was injured throughout the entire season. Strong performance at the U.S. National Championships to pull up from sixth after the short program after a bronze medal.
It's almost as if she's slowing down at the end, but the program is far more musical, far more controlled, far more complete than we've seen her do in the past years.
Well, it's very understandable that she doesn't have her usual spark and that drive and that aggressive spirit out here under the circumstances. She's still a very stunning figure to watch.
And you have to feel for her. How difficult the last 2 days must have been, and on her knees, obviously thinking about Carla. A prayer for her coach, Carla Fawcett, at the end of her free skate. Nicole Bobek of the United States and her U.S. teammate, the U.S. champion, the leader after the short program, Tara Lipinski, getting ready backstage. She will skate a little bit later on. Nicole Bobek along with Krista Fossey, Carlo's wife and one of her coaches, and Robin Cousins, the 1980 Olympic gold medalist, who also was coached by Carlo Fossey. You tend to forget that these are teenagers out here, and she's getting support from both of them right now. Technical merit marks for Nicole.
Well, I think it says a lot about Nicole's strength of character that she even competed here at this championship.
And her marks for presentation.
So I guess on the ice, Yulia Lavrenchuk, Ukraine.
Here is 18-year-old Yulia Lavrenchuk of Ukraine, the Ukrainian champion, who really surprised the skating world when she finished third after the bronze medal at this year's European Championships. A year ago in Edmonton, she finished 17th. So it's been quite a year for her.
So she's skating to the music of Malaguena.
One thing that she does have is great speed. Even if she is pumping her back up and down, she does get speed across the ice. And watch here, watch the pole vault reach. Practically no pole vault at all. No reach behind her. Revolution not complete. And there, of course, goes that jump.
Now watch this. This is an amazingly long setup for this next jump. Now watch, she just skates around the rink almost twice, preparing for this triple loop jump. More crossovers.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
And there it is.
And it was a nice one, too.
It was. worth waiting for, I guess.
I must say, to her credit, is that she has survived exceedingly difficult skating conditions in the Ukraine. The ice conditions there are almost non-existent. Victor Petrenko has had terrible trouble in trying to help them so that she can, when she can pull off a nice triple jump like that, she must be very encouraged.
Well, she told us that the one rink in which she skates and practices, the normal temperature is about 15 below. Maybe an exaggeration a little bit, but certainly tough conditions with which to train.
Not very inspiring. I think sometimes people are surprised that these skaters, in cold conditions like that, you do get very, very warm because you're moving around and spending so much energy. It takes a lot of energy and endurance to pull off all of these moves.
And there was
and skate
a day
for 4 minutes
when these championships were held outside.
Right, I was at the last outdoor world championships in Vienna, 67.
I was at the first.
We're a study in contrast here. Nice triple salchow. This combination spin, beautiful position in the layback, good speed.
In ninth place, trying to remain in the top 10, Yulia Lavrenchuk of Ukraine. The reigning world champion Michelle Kwan has arrived in the building. She skates with the leaders in the final group. Welcome back to the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. The ladies free skate taking place. Right now we take you over to check in with Leslie Visser. Leslie?
Thanks, Terry. A courageous effort today. Nicole, how difficult was it?
It was very difficult. I didn't skate very well, but I was trying really hard, and I just couldn't get under my legs. It's been a real tough 2 days, so I'm just glad that I was able to go out and do the best that I could, and which wasn't that great, but under the circumstances, I made it through.
And what about your gesture at the end? What were you trying to say?
I was just, thanking Carlo that, you know, that all the years he's done and being with me and just everything, and I wanted everyone to know how much I miss him and that I was trying to skate for him, and though it wasn't very well, I tried.
Well, it was a gift to him. Thanks, Nicole. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, thank you. Obviously, a very difficult week for Nicole Bobek here in her third trip to the World Championships. A difficult free skate for Yulia Lavrenchuk of Ukraine, her technical merit mark. She was in tears as she left the ice, and now her presentation marks. Not happy at all with her appearance here at Worlds.
Julia Lautova, Austria.
Well, here's a young skater who is only 15 years old, but is already the three-time Austrian national champion. In 11th place after the short program, Julia Lautova.
She has a very relaxed style. She almost looks like she skates like in a practice session. She looks so relaxed. Her opening jump is a triple Lutz jump. The preparation, tapping in. Good height, nice rotation in the air.
One of the things about this young lady is that she's really a very cute skater. She's energetic, she's young, she's immature. She looks and skates like a 15-year-old.
I think her body is very well proportioned for skating. Gives a beautiful line out there. She has good technique on her jumps, rotates very straight in the air.
By looking and skating like a 15-year-old now, it means that she might grow into a very accomplished skater. She certainly has the athletic ability and the line, the potential line for that.
That's nice and straight in the air, triple Salchow. A little trouble on the landing, but it was clean. Double toe. Of the 4-minute program made it look very easy.
You have a lot of energy when you're 15, don't you?
She looks very happy with herself.
She missed all of last year with a fractured right leg, so this is a comeback year. And what a year. Strong early success throughout the season and hoping to finish in the top 10 here at the World Championships. Yulia Lautova of Austria. Well, still to skate, the U.S. champion, the leader after the short program, and the favorite here, Tara Lipinski. Yeah, much better finish on hand this year.
And here's a look at one of the jumps she did very successfully in the program, a triple flip. Nice height, nice controlled landing, made it look very easy.
It's sort of nice watching her grow up sort of the way she should be.
First set of marks for technical merit. There you see them there. A range of 5.4 up to 5.6. This is a solid showing for her at Worlds. 5.3 up to 5.5. The range for presentation. She's in second place in terms of those that have skated. And now the first.